Namaskaram. My pranams to all my gurus, my first guru and my father Sri Lakshmi Narasimhan, Sangeetha Kalanidhi Professor S. Ramanathan, Kalaimamani Vairamangalam Lakshmi Narayana, Vidushi Srimati Jayalakshmi Santanam and Vidushi Srimati Meena Subramaniam. To me, raga is a very beautiful journey. Because of improvisations and compositions, every time this journey becomes very, very unique. We musicians strictly follow the lakshana of the raga. And we also give importance to the aesthetics. And every time we sing a raga, we re-experience the beauty of the raga. And every raga has a very strong personality and it can express emotions. It is up to us musicians to interpret the raga. And when you look at raga, there are many ways to look at a raga. You can look at a raga from a scalar point of view, that is arohanam, avarohanam, that is ascending notes and the descending notes that will define the raga. And there's another way of looking at a raga, phrases, that is connection between the notes. They call rakti ragas. And the connection between the notes actually give life to those ragas. And there was rakti ragas, very ancient, and I can give you some examples like Bhairavi, Kamboji, Thodi, etc. Now we can look at the raga from a note perspective. We can also look at it from what kind of emotion or expression that raga can give to us musicians as well, to the audience. And we can also look at it from whether it has a conflicting notes or whether raga has come from outside, like from the other genre to Carnatic. So you can look at raga from, you know, any way, in any, from any point of view. There are many ways to look at raga. But when we look at a scalar raga, where the arohana avrohana defines the raga, we have actually a system in place called Melakarta, which was created by a gifted musicologist who lived in the 17th century. His name was Venkatamaki. It has 72 Sampurna raga. Sampurna means all seven notes. And in that 36 ragas, the first 36 are being grouped and called Suddha Madhyama ragas. That means Madhyama 1. And the remaining 36 are being grouped into a Prati Madhyama ragas. That means Ma 2 ragas. And are there only two types of Madhyama? Not really. And what exactly is the meaning of Madhyama? Madhyamam typically means the middle of a scale. Like you have sa, ri, ga, the ma sits in between, and pa, da, ni. Madhyamam, madhyam also mean medium, which is used to convey an expression or an emotion. The emotion can be anything: happiness, sad, ecstasy, melancholy, aggression, you know, any kind of emotion. And this Madhyamam note is very, very important to many, many ragas. There are four types of Madhyamam. First is Suddha Madhyama, that is Ma 1. Shri Rukmini Sama Na Shri Rukmini. So that's the Madhyamam 1. So ಶುದ್ಧ ಮಧ್ಯಮ. ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ತೀವ್ರ ಶುದ್ಧ ಮಧ್ಯಮ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಲೈಟ್ಲಿ ಹಾಯರ್ ದನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ಡ್. ಅನು ಅನುದಿನ ಮುನುಗಾವು ಮೈಯ ಗಮ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಮಾ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಸಿಲೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಮಾ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ತೀವ್ರ ಶುದ್ಧ ಮಧ್ಯಮ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ರಾಗಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಬೇಗಡ ಆರ್ ಗೌಳಿ ಪಂತು. ದ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮಧ್ಯಮಂ. ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ದ ಮಧ್ಯಮಂ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ದ ನೇಮ್ ಬೇಗಡ ಮಧ್ಯಮಂ, ಆಲ್ದೋ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ತೀವ್ರ ಶುದ್ಧ ಮಧ್ಯಮಂ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಬೇಗಡ, ಯು ನೋ, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಟ್ ಮಧ್ಯಮಂ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಬೇಗಡ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮಧ್ಯಮ. ದೆನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರತಿ ಮಧ್ಯಮಂ. ನೋ ಪ್ರತಿ ಮಧ್ಯಮಂ, ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗಿವ್ ಯು ಇಸ್ ಕಲ್ಯಾಣಿ.
Kamala Pamagari Sanidani Vigari Pama.
So that's where the Prati Madhyamam sits, the second Madhyamam. Now there's another type of Madhyamam called Chuta Panchama Madhyamam. Which we normally find it in a raga called, say, Varali.
Kana kana ruchira kana kana kana.
So it's the, if you assume that panchamam is a bit lower, you know, than its position, then that's the chuta panchama Madhyama. And apart from this, there are Dvi Madhyama ragas. Like some ragas will have both the Shuddha Madhyama and the Prati Madhyama. Like for example, Amir Kalyani.
Mana mule tha tanavadani abhima.
So you can hear both the Madhyama, Sutta and the Prati Madhyama. There is also Dvi Madhyama, there is two Madhyama, Panchama Varjya ragas also. A great legend, late S. Kalyan Raman, had done a big research on this particular topic. The presence of this
Ma,
so the presence of the Tivra Madhyama, it brings up a lot of you know, exciting possibilities in terms of manodharma, improvisations or expressions. And to me, that particular note or any Prathimadhyama raga, they're more melodious, they're very majestic, and they're very pleasant to hear. And we can go on and on, and I'm sure every musician will agree to this. Now the topic today is actually, you know, a Prathimadhyama note is very magical. That particular
Ma,
it's very magical in my opinion. And I can demonstrate this in four different ways, or you can say four different approaches. Like I already said, you know, it's up to us how to look. We can look at a raga from any point of view. Based on those four approaches, I will take examples today. The first is scalar. So we can look at a raga from a scalar point of view. In this scalar approach, I'll take three ragas for example. Now before we before I talk about the scalar, I would like to mention this. Generally there is a thought that a phrase-based ragas, you know, as I mentioned earlier, the Rakti ragas are very ancient. The phrase-based ragas are superior than the scale-based raga. So that's a thought, you know. I mean, to me, all ragas are superior. No raga is inferior for me. Because the uniqueness lie in how we deal with these ragas, how we how much do we internalize the compositions, how much we try to explore, how much of manodharma do we use to explore that raga, and that makes it magical. Now in the scalar approach,
ajanmamu bettalu damavadiloni japamu mukti margam anukoni.
Okay, so this is a raga called Suddha Saveri.
Sarima padasa sadabamari sa, sarima padasa dabamari sa.
It's a very fast paced raga, Suddha Saveri. It's a beautiful, beautiful raga. It's a Suddha Madhyama raga. So what I just sang is a Madhyama one.
Sadabama padadabama pamari rima padapamari marisa.
Now this Madhyamam, the Shuddha Madhyamam, let's change that to a Prati Madhyama raga, or just change it to a Prati Madhyama note.
Sarima pada sadapa marisa, sarima pada sadapa marisa, sarima pada sanidapa madapa madapa mari. Nive jiva shakti, nive jnana mukti, nive jiva pama. Sarima pada sanida nida pada pama.
Now what you heard was, it's a raga called Saraswati. It's a very sweet raga, you know, that's the definition I can give. And it's also, it went from Carnatic music, migrated to Hindustani music, and it's very well used in Saraswati. It's evolved a lot. Now
sarima pada sad nida pamari sa.
Now let's call the re ga.
Sa ga ma pada san da pamaga sa.
Let's take the knee off, the nishadam off.
Sa ga ma pada sa da pamaga sa.
Let's add a conflicting note, vivad.
Saga ma pada sa da pa ma ga sa, sari ga ma pada sa da pa ma ga re sa, da pa ma u pada sa sa da pa ma ga re sa da pada sa da sa da sari ga ma pada sa da pa ma da pa ma ga re sa.
So this raga is called Chandrajyoti. Chandrajyoti is a very soulful raga. So as you could see, you know, from a scalar point of view, if you look at it, Suddha Saveri beautifully becoming a very fast-paced Suddha Saveri, beautifully becoming a very sweet raga called Saraswati, and then you add a Vivadi note into it, it becomes Chandrajyoti. Very soothing, very soulful raga. Now I will present a very famous composition, Bhagayanaya.
Na 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 na
Example is let's take the very famous Thodi. Now the Thodi ragam, you all know, we all know, it's a very powerful dynamic raga, you know. Now the Thodi, in the Thodi, when you change, Thodi is a Suddha Madhyama raga. Now let's change the note, the Suddha Madhyamam, to a Prati Madhyamam. What we get is a beautiful, a very devoted raga called Bhavapriya. Now this Bhavapriya raga, there's only Sri Kanthini, you know, Tyagaraja's only composition probably, and I will take an example, not the Bhavapriya, but a child raga of Bhavapriya, which is called Bhavani. Bhavani is basically a Panchama Varjiya raga. My guru, Professor S. Ramanathan Mama, he composed a beautiful composition, Bhavapriya Bhavani, that is in praise of Kamakala Kameshwari Ambar in triplicate. The beauty is the way S. Ramanathan Mama has handled Bhavani in this composition is completely different from the way M.M. Dandabani Desikar has handled Bhavani in his composition Unai Andri Uttrutunai. It's completely different, but that gives us a different dimension, you know, two different dimensions for this raga, and this Bhavani is so peaceful, you know, it's a peaceful raga, and that's because of the Madhyama note.
Bhavani Bhavani Gapanisanipagarisa.
We all know what raga it is, Hamsadhwani. It's a very speed raga. It's a very nice raga. fast raga. Now in this hamsa dhwani, let's take the re off.
Sa ga pa ni sa sa ni pa ga sa ga pa ni pa ga pa ni pa ga pa ga sa sa ga pa ga pa ni pa ni sa ni pa ga sa.
This raga is called Shankari. It's a very very rare raga. It's not so much known. Might be compositions, I don't know. Now in this raga Shankari,
sa ga pa ni sa ni pa ga sa,
let's add a pratimadhima.
Sa ga pa ni sa ni pa ma ga sa, sa ga ma ga ma ga sa ni pa ni sa ni pa ni pa ma pa ma ga ga ma pa ni sa sa ga ma ga.
We all know Amritavarshini. It's a beautiful magical raga, a rain raga. So I'll sing the composition of M.M. Dandapani Deshikar in this raga.
Sunny, baniza niza ga sa ga ma ga ma ba ma ba ni baniza ni ba ma ga sa sa ni ba ma ga ba ba ni ennai ni maravade angayar kanni angayar kal ni angayar kal
Second approach. So, in the second approach, I am actually going to take the Rakti Raga, Rakti Pratimadhyama Raga. It's a very famous raga called Purvi Kalyani. It's a very aesthetically melodious raga and a very pleasant raga. And the beauty in this raga is, of course, there are so many compositions in Purvi Kalyani. The list goes on. The madhyamam usage in this raga has so many colors.
Madamagare sa sarigama pamagare sa nidamagare sa gamadamagare sa.
So it's like this madhyamam, it is like it's the same madhyamam, but the way it sounds, you know, the way it holds the panchamam and the way it comes out, you know, it has many, many colors. Like, for example,
Iniyagilum ninai maname Iniyagilum 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 Iniyagilu ninai maname iragule nilagane ragavale iniyagilu.
Now the third approach, as I already mentioned, you know, madhyam is also a medium. So madhyamam note, it takes a huge responsibility, you know, and becomes a beautiful medium to express different emotions, all possible emotions, I would say. How is that possible? It is possible. I can give you a very beautiful example. This example is known to all musicians.
Shri Valli Devase Napate Shri Valli Sarigama Padani Sansanidavama Nidavama Rigamo Pamagarisa Rigamo Padani Sanidavamagarisa.
This raga is called Nattabhairavi. It's a very sober raga. In this Nattabhairavi, it's a Suddha Madhyama raga. Let's change the note to Pratimadhyama. You can guess it.
Mahasuram ke to maham pamagarisa sarigama padanisa nida padanisa nida pamagarisa nida nisarigama nida pama padanida nibanida pama padavama padanapama padavama padavama pamagarisa.
A sober raga suddenly becomes, you know, suddenly changes the entire atmosphere and to a, you know, dynamic mode. That's because of the madhyama. This raga that I just changed now is Shanmugapriya. As we all know, Shanmugapriya is a very, very versatile raga and can bring out almost every, all possible emotions. Could be bhakti, it could be shringara rasam, karuna rasam, adbhutam.
Na na na.
it's not a ghana raga, but still it's a very captivating raga. I will now sing a composition of my grandfather, late Kumaramangalam Srinivas Raghavan. He was a very big composer, a big vagekara who composed at least 500 compositions. There are so many compositions in Chanmugapriya, but I will sing my grandfather's Kumaramangalam Srinivas Raghavan's composition to demonstrate why I feel that this Pratimadhyama can give so many colors, you know, that I can only explain it through the composition, the Neravam.
பக்தி மார்க்கம் தெரியேன் வணங்கு வழி அறியேன் பக்தி மார்க்கம் தெரியேன் வணங்கு வழி அறியேன் பக்தி மார்க்கம் தெரியேன் வணங்கு வழி அறியேன் முக்தி சாதனங்கள் அறிய பெற்றேன் பக்தி மார்க்கம் தெரியேன் வணங்கு வழி அறியேன் முக்தி சாதனங்கள் அறிய பெற்றேன் சக்தி காண சக்தி காண அறிவு மாற்றனும் கொண்டேனேன் சக்தி காண அறிவு மாற்றனும் கொண்டேனேன் ரக்தி ராகவர லயகீதம் தெரியேன் ரக்தி ராகவர லயகீதம்
रक्ति राग वर लयगेद गणो विलंगुरे अंगणो तुलंगुंदलेवा मेपुरुले गणो विलंगु
Now the last approach is, you know, as I earlier mentioned, a raga, if it has a couple of conflicting notes, or even if it has all conflicting notes, the madhyamam, the prati madhyamam, it basically acts like a mother and pulls all of those conflicting notes together and gives us a beautiful swarupam and lots of improvisation scope as well. And for that I will take the best example that anyone can think of, the 72nd raga, which is the last raga in the Melakarta, and it's a raga that has been loved by all rasikas, rasika priya, and I'll sing the very famous composition, Arul Seiya Venumayya Kotishwara.
Na 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 முருகையா நீ அருள் செய்ய வேணுமையா அரசே முருகையா நீ அருள் செய்ய வேணும் ஐயா அரசே முருகையா நீ அருள் செய்ய வேணும் ஐயா அரசே முருகையா நீ அருள் செய்ய வேணும் ஐயா முருகையா முருகையா அரசே முருகையா நீ அருள் செய்ய வேணும் ஐயா முருகையா நிலையா காயம் இல்லையே இதனை நிலையா காயம் இல்லையே இதனை நிலையா காயம் இல்லையே காயம் இளையனை நிலையுடள்ளுவார் என்னமாயும் நிலையால் காயம் இளையனை நிலையுடள்ளுவார் என்னமாயும் நிலையோ துணை ரசிக பிரிய நேச கவி குல்ஜராதாசன் ரசிக பிரிய நேச கவி குல்ஜராதாசன் ரசிக பிரிய அருள் செய்ய வேணும் ஐயா அரசே முருகையா நீ அருள் செய்ய வேணும் ஐயா முருகை
My Guru's Guru, my Guru Vairamangalam Lakshmi Narayan's Guru, T.K. Rangachari, he was a great legend and he used to explore the ragam Vagadishwari. It's a very rare raga for half an hour or even more, for hours, without even touching that Rishabham note. I think the rasikas will say, oh okay, he's singing Harikambuja, and then slowly he will, you know, he'll explore the lower with the Rishabham. Why I'm saying this is, it's up to us musicians how we explore the ragas. Some pratimadhyama ragas didn't even exist in the past. Rakti ragas could be very very ancient, but some pratimadhyama ragas, they never existed in the past. They're pretty new, and they originated as only scales. But over time they acquired beautiful gamakas, and that's because of the creativity of the musicians. Pratimadhyama ragas have evolved like vivadi ragas. They keep evolving, and all ragas can create feelings, has a personality, and it can create experience for us musicians as well as the audience. All that matters is how we experience the raga. Like how my guru always used to tell me, the more we sing a raga, the deeper we dwell into it. And raga anubhavam cannot be ranked. Every raga is superior. Namaskar.
Thank you very much, Vidushi Srimati Gayatri Bharat, for that excellent discussion on Pratimadhyama ragas. Now that we have heard about raga presentation, could you please tell us a little more about how the essence of a raga is brought out with the lyrics of the composition through the concept of nirava?